A case that's getting national attention is under the microscope in Kansas City tonight.
It was a hearing before the Missouri Court of Appeals for 28-year-old Ryan Ferguson, convicted of murder 9 years ago. Peggy Bright was in the courtroom. Peggy?
Laura, there was a lively interchange right back here at the Court of Appeals between the three appellate judges, Ferguson's lawyer, and the Assistant Attorney General for Missouri. At the end of it all, the people in Ferguson's camp came away feeling they were the clear winner.
The judges came in prepared to ask good questions, and the Attorney General was not prepared to give good, valid, rational answers.
The questions came fast at the lawyers right from the start, with the judges showing a comprehensive knowledge of the case.
And his exact words, I think, were to the effect, Mr. Trump told us he could identify Mr. Ferguson and Mr. Erickson. He characterized it as an exciting new development.
She's talking about evidence critical to Ferguson's conviction in the murder of Columbia sports editor Ken Heidholt, Halloween night 2001. Heidholt was found dead in the newspaper's parking lot. There was physical evidence at the scene, including hair, footprints, and a shoe print, and none was tied to Ryan Ferguson. But Ferguson's friend Chuck Erickson testified they were both in on it. Erickson has since recanted. And a janitor from the paper says he saw Ferguson at the scene. He has recanted as well. The judges heard today about many instances of so-called Brady violations when the prosecution doesn't give information to the defense. The judges played them up. The prosecution played them down.
You know, I guess you can look at the evidence in different ways. I mean, Mr. Ferguson has marshaled the evidence in one way and wants to view it in one way and draw certain insinuations.
The guy was like a chicken running around in a hailstorm trying to dodge the hail, and the hail was in the form of Brady violations.
Bill Ferguson says he believes the judges will rule in his son's favor, whether for Brady violations or for outright innocence. The ruling is expected sometime within the next couple of months. Live downtown in Kansas City, Peggy Bright, KMBC 9 News.
Bill Ferguson says no matter how the judges rule, he expects an appeal to the state Supreme Court. But if it goes his way, he thinks Ryan might be freed on bond, pending the possibility of another trial.